很值得我们现代人深思的一个问题就是，应当如何踏上一条能够完善生命、自利利他的修持之道？面对拥有几千年灵性修持历史的古老传统，我们或许不禁要问：什么才是佛教最核心的、最精髓的教法？如何学习并在生活中运用与实践这些教法？那么今天我们很幸运。
As a matter of fact, this precious teaching, uninterruptedly transmitted through over 1,000 years, is also one of the main sources of inspiration for Rinpoche himself. He received the teaching at a very young age and put it as his daily practice since then. We can certainly say that Rinpoche himself is a living embodiment of compassion and wisdom, the heart of the teaching given in 8 verses for training the mind by
Lang日堂巴。来自朗日堂巴这一珍贵的教法，到如今已经有上千年无有间断的传承。事实上，它也是仁波切本人不断获得启示。 与古物的源泉，仁波切很小就获得了此法的传承。从那时起，就一直作为他日常修持的功课。我们完全可以这样说，仁波切自己已完整地实践了这一教法的核心，那就是智慧与慈悲的圆满融合。So,
without further ado, please join me in welcoming Rinpoche to give us the teaching titled Light Up Your Life with Compassion. Before he starts, Rinpoche will first lead us to chart the 8 noble auspicious ones composed by the great Mipang Rinpoche.
那么不再耽误大家时间，现在有请仁波切为我们开示，题目是慈悲点亮人生。在正式开始之前，请仁波切
Sambha Jinpo Dengchon Chenhe Mardang Namdang Gyarpa Yangur Chon Bharje Bodha Zawamma Namdo Chudu Lhabze Ngurdo Dang Chajir Lhabze Dangda Durje Bhoga Rajan Chudu Jansan Sasan is a gala jazir, burn your day, your gala jumper, Daja dander jarzuma, Godan yeran seva gushin, Doda harbor zamda yajan, Trajidila bosom sober.
<笑>没有是吧你们有没有其他的
今天很荣幸 我们在做现场的一些佛教导游，还有我们电视网络上的来自各个地方的一些朋友啊，我呢今天利用这个事件，给大家非常简单的解释一下，今。 应该800多年前的藏传佛教当中非常著名的拉尔唐巴尊者的修行罢诵，同时呢，我也想给大家传授这个法的传承。So today,
I feel great honored that there are lots of Dharma friends here, and also there are also Dharma friends watching it through the internet or TV that all over different places. So today I want to use this opportunity to first briefly explain the 8 verses for training the mind, which is composed by the great master Lhartampa for about 800 years ago. And also I will use this opportunity to give you the reading transmission of the test.
<coughs> 在我们藏传佛教当中，这个修行罢诵非常著名。 可能在座的很多朋友呢，应该有所听闻，因为它的这种意义表面上看呢比较简单，因为只有8个颂词，但实际上呢意义深远，我个人而言也是经过很多年。 很早以前，得到过这个传承，当时呢，上师如意宝鸡鸣本座法王，就亲自传授过很多次，但是呢，
So, the test, eight verses for training the mind. Actually, in Tibetan Buddhism, it is very famous. I think lots of Dharma friends may heard about it before. But actually, there are only eight simple verses. But actually, the meaning is very deep and profound. And I actually received the transmissions. I received the transmission several times by the His Holiness, Jinmei Pongso Rinpoche. But if we really want to put what is said into practice, it is not very easy.
其实这部法对我来讲很早以前都接触过，并且呢。 我自己也把它当作我自己的课诵当中的最重要的一个法，我这个笔记本呢，是82年，1982年我初中毕业的时候买的，然后来就这个修行八颂呢，在法王面前得到之后，我就抄在这个里面，很早以前80年代的时候。 然后呢，应该说，这个对我来讲是陪伴之后很多年呢，对这个法就很有感情，很有信心，很欢喜。说实在，要实际行动当中做的话呢，虽然比较难，但我还是在一直努力着。
So the test, although I received the transmission earlier, but since then I put the test into one of my important daily lessons. And the notebook I just showed you, it is in the year 1982 that when I graduated from a middle school, I bought it. And then around 1980s, I copied the test, the eight verses for training the mind, into this notebook. And then it kept it accompanied with me for a long time. And although it is hard to put the eight verses into practice, actually, but I have great faith and great joy on this text.
在座的人应该知道，其实任何一个法，获得传承，这是非常重要。一般藏传佛教自古以来对传承的重视，并且要求如果没有得到传承的话，那么这部法呢不能与他人传授。这一点呢，就像我们现在的任何的一些。 包括中药的一些技术吧，就是也需要前辈人的这种亲手的传递，亲手的这样的这个传下，比如说我们的一些医学的知识啊，就是中医的一些技术啊，或者说是实践当中的很多很多的秘诀，就很需要就。 前面人的这种传承，所以呢，我想今天一边呢跟大家念传承，一边呢就是也是这个修行八颂的简单的这种字面的意思呢，也给大家就解释。And
we all know that the getting lineages or getting transmission is very important, and especially in Tibetan Buddhism. It is said that if you don't have the lineage, actually, then you cannot transmit this text to other people. Likewise, in our world, some important technology, we also need the lineages. We need some old or experienced people to transmit this technology to you, like some Chinese tradition medicine and so forth. So today, I will give you the reading transmission or oral transmission of the test, and then provide a brief introduction of it.
The first verse reads, by thinking of all sentient beings as more precious than wish-fulfilling jewel, for accomplishing the highest aim, I will always hold them dear. So actually this verse talks about the loving kindness and compassion. So it actually more precious or more valuable than the wish-fulfilling jewel. And we should always think of to help others and to give our love to other sentient beings, and so the love and compassion can always keep company with us. But nowadays, I think a lot of people, they only do something for the selfish purpose. But I think we should eradicate this, and we should always help others. And here they use some very precious thing to be a metaphor. It says that so all the sentient beings or the altruistic mind or the so the idea that want to benefit others is more precious.
就是说孤单呢，抱住，就因为孤单的很多的教义都是，这个，金刚钻石啊，如意宝啊，或者说是其他的珍宝，来，就送命他的价值。那么从现在的一些价值观来看呢，就是我们所谓的金钱呢，就金钱也是人们都当做是非常珍贵的，也就是说我要把这些众生呢，就是当做是最珍贵的，有一种爱心呢，就是无有任何的偏度，就是平等的，就是一视同仁的，要向帮助别人，就这样的一颗心呢，我们时时刻刻的是要需要保持，需要护持。
So here it says that the altruistic mind is actually more precious than a wish-fulfilling jewel. So in ancient times, we use a treasure or some other things in order to see its values. But according to our value system today, I think the money may be actually like the wish-fulfilling jewel. So actually the sentient beings are very important and precious, and we should, we should love them, and love them all, and it shouldn't that we should love them equally.
爱众生的心呢，实际上不要没有骗度的，也就是说，我们这个太阳阳光啊，就是它照耀整个大地的时候呢，它不可能有骗度之心。同样的，我们爱心，我们爱众生的这种心呢，就是像阳光一样，就是普及整个所有天下的众生。 我们有时候也应该看看我们现在的自私自利心什么时候断掉，一定要尽量的让提升自己的这种爱他的心。So
here it talks about the altruistic mind, or the mind to benefit others, and it should be equal across all sentient beings. It's just like the sunlight when the sun is shining, and then the sunlight just across all different places. So the altruistic mind, it should be just like the sunlight. So we should love all sentient beings equally.
这是修行八颂当中第一个颂词，听懂了没有？
This is the first verse. Do you understand or?
<笑>刚刚的四当中不在，等你跟两马大将，人了，人了三把特把一，求的基本怎么修？那么这个就是说，无论是我们接触任何人，无论在任何地方，在任何时候，只要跟其他人交往的时候呢。 我们把自己当作是应该最卑下的，就不能高高在上，就是存有这种傲慢之心。而且呢，这样的心态呢，并不是假意的、假装的，是真诚的，就是真心诚意的。也就是说，这样的这种爱心呢，我们要时时刻刻都，不是爱心，就这样的谦卑的心呢，我们。
So, the second verse reads, whenever I am in the company of others, I will regard myself as the lowest among all, and from the depths of my heart, cherish others as supreme. And this verse talks about, you know, when no matter anyone we meet or any place we go, when we communicate with other people, we should always regard ourselves as the lowest among all. We shouldn't be arrogant. And this kind of humble is not that we pretend it to be. It should be from the depths of my heart that we cherish others as
刚才这里说，无论是借助什么样的人呢，把自己当作是最卑下的，这样的这种理念，也许很多人认为，我们现在这个21世纪的人们的心态啊，可能有所向外，因为现在很多人认为，展示自我的强大。 展示自我的勇敢，展示自我的成功。那么，如果把自己当做一个很卑下、卑微，或者说自己很弱小的，就这样谦虚的话呢，也许无法展示自我的一个本质。因此，可能尤其是跟西方文化的有些人的历练呢，也许觉得是不符合，可能有些人会不会有这样？
So here it talks about anyone that we meet, we should regard ourselves as the lowest. Then I think some people may think that maybe it's a little bit contradict to our attitude in 21st century, because nowadays lots of people believe that we should show ourselves, we should show that we are powerful and we have courage and we're successful. But here it tells us that we should think that we are lowest, we are small, we are tiny. And some people may think that then we cannot show ourselves. And maybe it's also contradict to the ideas of the Western culture. I don't know whether you will have this kind of belief or not.
但实际上呢，真正自我的谦卑呢，对自己来讲是应该非常有意义的，因为我们在这个事件当中。 往往很多错误都是，以自我的这种傲慢，就是骄傲自满，就是有这样的一种心态，就是导致的。再说呢，你们有可能听过，就是以前印度有一个文学家，也是获得诺贝尔奖的得主吧，就是泰戈尔，他说过，不管是什么人，什么时候非常谦卑的话呢？ 那么这个人已经接近最伟大的了，所以从中我们可以看出了，人谦卑的时候呢，实际上是他接近于伟大的时刻了。So,
but in fact, so this kind of humble is actually beneficial, or it is meaningful for all of us, and lots of our mistakes. If we think it carefully, it's because of our arrogant. And I don't know whether you heard one of the quote by a poet, and he's also a Nobel Prize winner, a tiger. And he says that we come nearest to the great when we are great in humility.
有时候我经常观察自己的时候呢，自己很谦卑，很不错；有时候呢，我观察自己的时候，自己很傲慢，就很惭愧。不管怎么样呢，其实需要这样的一种修行的教养来经常鞭策自己，经常监督自己，这也是非常重要的。 我们很多人，就每天就是需要，起来，洗脸、刷牙，然后还要照镜子。但是这是身体上的一个观察，对我们的内心的这个一面镜子呢，很多人比较缺少。所以，我像修心巴颂那样的一个小镜子，经常带在自己的身边的话呢。
So sometimes I observe myself, and I think that I am okay. I'm humble, but sometimes I feel that I'm arrogant. So I think we need this kind of test in order to really observe ourselves or observe our mind. Just like every morning we wash our face and tooth, and sometimes we look ourselves, look our body in the mirror and so on. It's just observation of our body, but we also need a kind of mirror to look into our mind, to see our mind. I think if you take the 8 verses for training the mind like a small mirror, that it can you can really use this mirror to look or observe your mind.
其实我们现在如果没有经常观察的话，我觉得很多人知识方面不缺，因为现在以上网的时候呢，什么样的知识呢就分着它了，就很容易，展现在自己的身上，自己的前面。但是我们现在缺少的，应该说欣赏和立赏啊，就刚才我认为是所谓的知识。 就是现在很多人来讲是不缺少，所谓的立上，也就是说，当你面对任何痛苦的时候呢，就是面对痛苦的这种勇敢或者方法，许多人来讲比较缺少，还有一个自己的所谓的亲身，我们做人的基本的道德，跟别人借助的这种很多的能力呢，现在人越来越欠缺。
Nowadays, if we didn't observe the world in details, I think we know that we don't lack knowledge, because if there is massive, if you search the internet or go to some places, there are massive knowledge that can be shown. But actually, I think the intelligence quotient or the IQ, I think we don't like IQ, but the emotional quotient or the EQ that we really like, it is a basic quality that we communicate with others, and we also like a kind of ability that when we face the suffering or we face the pain, the hurt, how to get rid of it, how to become courage, and to find a way to relieve from the pain. I think we lack this.
我今天看到一个新闻呢，说是有一位女的双重博士，中国在中国毕业了，就是最好的一个博士，应该博士后吧，然后到美国去游读了一个博士后。 这样的这个双重博士和后来在工作的过程当中，人和企业、人和单位呢都没有办法跟人相处，最后谁都不要，最后自己变成一种流浪者，在厕所啊，在桥洞里啊，就一直过一个非常凄惨的生活。但后来呢，就他的护照已经过期了，就被这个警察已经诉讼到这个国内。 从他的很多的这种这个照片也好，就是他的各方面的这个形式来看的话呢，就是的确是非常可怜的，非常可怜的。其实我们很多人可能很有智慧，但是在做人的过程当中，因为自己很傲慢，因为自己很得意，这样的原因就不愿意接受别人的教训。 所以呢，在生活中当中啊，就经常遇到了非常的这种困难，甚至呢，很有可能自己的精神就是不正常。So
there is a news today. There is a woman who has 2 postdoctors and. One is from China. So after he got this postdoctor, he graduated from China after finishing one postdoctor, and then he went to the United States and get another postdoctor. And just this person, and she, and because her behavior is terrible, and then no firms want to hire or employ her. And in the end, she became homeless, and she she wandered in the street and in some in the toilet in the arch of the bridge, and it is very pity. And then when her passport expired and she was sent back to China, so we see from the pictures, you know, it is very a pity and it's very sad. So nowadays, lots of people, they have knowledge, they're brilliant, so they have high IQ, but they don't know how to be a right person, so they are arrogant, they're very arrogant, so they cannot receive or accept other people's advice. Then if you become that state, then I think there will be a lot of difficulties in your life.
这是第二个颂词，下面第三个颂词啊，修冷根的让人家了，多讲你莫解嘛的，德人马龙学别呢，赞同动的罗布尔学，那么这第三颂的意思呢？ 我们在任何的时候啊，做什么事情呢，应该要观察自己的身体、语言、心态，因为很有可能我们心里面就是会产生贪心、嗔心、痴心、傲慢、嫉妒等等，就是这些烦恼。如果我们没有立即把它根除的话呢，很有可能就是这些烦恼呢， 对自己也是有害的，对他人也会有害的。So
the third verse reads, in my every action, I will watch my mind, and the moment destructive emotions arise, I will confront them strongly and avert them, since they will hurt both me and others. So this verse tells us that every time and whatever things we do, we should pay attention to our body, speech, and mind. If we don't do it like that, it is highly possible that there are certain afflictions will arise in our mind, like attachment, hatred, and arrogance, and so forth, and it will do harm to us.
大家都知道，可能。 很多人也讲嗔心，生嗔恨心的危害。我们在座的人都知道是发脾气呢，对自己也不利，对他人也不利。但是有很多人也认为好像生贪欲心没有这么恐怖，因为依靠一种贪欲，依靠一种爱，对自他的生活呢也带来一种幸福，所以对贪欲的。 这种价值观方面呢，可能有些人是也有不同的观点。I
think a lot of people know that hatred is bad for us because we all have these experiences. But when you are angry at something, it will hurt both yourself and others. But some people may think it is okay to have desire or okay to have attachment because they think that if you have attachment and because of this attachment, this love, and it will benefit both yourself and others. So for the attachment or for the desire, maybe you have different opinions about it.
但是如果我们用智慧来观察的时候呢， 实际上，贪欲对我们带来的痛苦，对我们带来的危害呢，也是不低于嗔恨心。我们在座的人很多知道，在生活当中呢，经常因为贪欲而苦恼，因为贪欲而丧失了自己的一切的。
拥有的美好。
But if we consider the attachment using our wisdom, we may have the feeling that a lot of miserable experiences and a lot of sufferings are actually caused by the desire or by the attachment. It actually it not smaller than the hatred or the aversion. So because of the attachment, sometimes we are not feeling okay, and we are fear, and sometimes we lost. Sometimes we lost a lot of things because of the attachment.
啊，有时候可能因为贪欲带来了自己的不健康，不仅是心灵不健康，还有身体上也不健康。因为有些人就为了贪着自己的美好，包括就是现在很多年轻人呢、啊，就健肺。就吃一些健肺的药，甚至过午不食。很多人因为很想把自己的身体变成很苗条，就是所以呢，就是保持这个过午不吃，不但是过午不吃，上午不吃，还有呢，就好几天当中不吃饭的人呢。也听说是非常多。
Sometimes because of the desire or the attachment, it can cause a health problem, not only in our mental level, but also in our physical level, that we become unhealthy. And nowadays, a lot of people, they are trying to lose weight, and they take different medicines in order to lose weight, and some of them, they don't take meals after the mid of the day in order to keep thin or be thin. And for some of them, they even have no meal for an entire day and even for a couple of days.
本来那个出家人呢，就是佛陀的戒律里面要求过午不食，但是现在出家人呢，因为不执着自己的身体，害怕胖啊，就所以出家人当中也是经常有过午这个过了午之后呢，就是下午吃饭的人也比较多。啊，我说
出家人因为怎么？
就是说。本来佛陀在戒律里面说出家人是过午不吃嘛，但是因为出家人不怕胖，就所以下午吃饭的人也多。
So originally for the monastic people, because of the discipline, so they cannot take meals after the middle of the day. But actually, because these days that all the monastic people, they don't fear to be fat. So a lot of monastic people, they will choose to take meal after the middle of the day.
不过现在你们可能知道，到了这个西方国家的时候，西方的听说很多模特儿，他们是以这个身体非常瘦为名，就是身体特别瘦的话呢，就是很美，就这样之后，很多模特儿就甚至有些时候是六天当中就只是吃一两厘米啊。原来释迦牟尼佛也是在苦行的时候呢，也是就是喝一滴水啊，就吃一颗米啊，就是有这样的历史。所以现在就是特别讲究这个自己的这种美的这种身体啊，
就庄严的身体呢，也是就经常就是不吃饭，就是通过这种方式来就开始苦行。最后呢，自己对他们的身体受到就一定的影响，甚至呢对生命就是也有这个危害的。
Nowadays, a lot of models in the Western countries. So according to the current appreciation of the beauty, so they believe that being thin is very beautiful. So a lot of models, they only eat several grains of rice, maybe in within 6 days. It's like the Buddha Shakyamuni, that when he is practicing, he only drink tiny water and just several grains of rice. And because they like to be thin and they like to be beautiful, so they don't take meals. So they use this kind of ways, but actually it is very bad. It has an adverse effect on our body and life.
所以最近就是像美国啊，还有法国啊，很多国家就出台一些新的政策，要改变这种观念，但是呢也非常困难。其实这样的现象呢，归根结底也是跟我们的贪欲直接或者是间接是有关系的。
So therefore, these days, like the United States and France, they have some policies about this in order to change the idea system, to change this phenomenon. But actually, it is hard. So the phenomenon I just described is also related to it related to the attachment or desire sometimes directly and also indirectly.
第三个种族，现在是第四个种族。人人安比三千年，都得找别农民族，人只能带当吃白粮，你不能改为金针小。那么这个颂词的意思呢，就是说我们遇到一些非常恶劣、性格恶劣的这样的众生，还有呢遇到了就嫉妒的这种痛苦的就这样的众生的时候呢，就像我们遇到了特别珍贵的珍宝一样的，以难得的心呢，就是就帮助他。那么这是我们不管是在什么时候呢，看见特别可怜的众生，看见特别野蛮的众生，或者性格极其暴躁的这样的众生的时候呢，我们不能有非常这个愤恨的这种心态来，就是想抛弃他，想舍弃他，而我们应该用一种非常难得的心来，就接受他，帮助他。
And so the fourth verse reads, whenever I see ill-natured people or those overwhelmed by heavy misdeeds or suffering, I will cherish them as something rare, as though I'd find a priceless treasure. So this verse talks about ill-natured people, so the ill-natured or some really miserable, suffering people. And when we meet this kind of people, we should cherish them as something rare, and we should help them. When we encounter some really petty, people, and also some of them, the personalities are very bad, and we cannot abandon them. We should help them as though we find a priceless treasure.
那么这个道理也是可能现在有些人觉得非常不好的人呢，我们应该遗弃他，抛弃他，不应该接受，因为他对人类对我们有害的。其实从另一个层面来想的时候呢，这些人也是非常可怜。我们如果在这个世界上有人帮助他呢，非常有必要的。我最近呢就经常去一些监狱，你们都知道是监狱里面的这些人的人格也好，他们所做的事情呢应该是超越一些界限的，就是非常过分的。但是呢如果接近他们的话呢，其实他们被烦恼就去世的，他们没有自由。同时呢他们也最需要帮助的人，在我们这个事件当中的话呢，可能我们身边就是还有很多恶劣的人的时候呢，你有没有这个勇气来帮他？当然我们平常人的一些生活观念讲可能不一定要帮他，但是如果高层次的一个心态的话呢，可能我们对世界上的所有的被遗弃的恶劣的人或者坏人都要需要帮助。
So this verse, maybe some people will think that it also, so maybe it also contradicts to some of our ideas. Some people may think that, they are bad people, they are ill-natured people, we should really abandon them and we should really discard them. We will not accept it because it will do a lot of harm to us. But actually, if we consider it from another perspective, they are also sad and they need great care. And this is a particular group that we need to practice our loving kindness and compassion. And I also went to some prison, and the prisoners or the inmates, you know their personalities and the things they did, you know, they reach some certain limit, so they were in prison. But when we really get close to them, you will feel that they are also controlled by the afflictions, by the negative disturbing emotions. So they really need help. But the problem is here is that whether you have such courage to help them or to practice your loving kindness and compassion. But I think for some people with higher attitude or will have more moral standards, I think they will care all the people.
第五个松子啊，德拉现金吃不透的，西格拉松不是比，中卡人个人吧的，杰卡人难不容易。对我而言，有些人因为嫉妒心，因为其他的原因呢，就开始进行这个诽谤，或者说是对我进行伤害。按我们实践的一些道理来讲，别人无缘无故的诽谤我、伤害我，我应该以牙还牙，我应该要害他。但是按照大乘佛教的精神来讲呢，不但不损害他，还有所有的失败、亏损都自己的某某的代数，将自己的生理还要一切的这种成功呢，就是全部都奉献给他。那么这种精神呢，也可能按照世间的常规的观念来讲是不一定能接受，但的确，大乘佛教的最不共的一种精神来讲呢，它非常有意义的。
So the fifth verse reads, whenever someone out of envy does me wrong by attacking or belittling me,I will take defeat upon myself and give the victory to others. So here it says that if someone out of envy or some other reasons they attack us, attack us or belittles us. From the ordinary perspective, we will think that if other people hit us or they harm us, we should get revenge. But here in this verse it says that we should take defeat upon myself and give victory to others. So maybe this kind of spirit, it also cannot be accepted by a lot of people. But this is the particular feature or particular spirit of the Mahayana Dharma, and it is very meaningful.
这一个偈颂呢实际上在我们藏传佛教当中是非常著名的。你们可能很多人学习过普贤上师演讲，大圆满虔信的人呢都应该清楚，以前这个恰尔卡瓦格西就当时恰尔卡瓦格西的话呢就是在这个夏拉瓦格西的树里面就是看到这么一个颂册，后来他想方设法去寻找。他寻找的时候呢他亲自步行就是从康区到就是拉萨，最后找到这个朗日唐巴故乡的时候呢，朗日唐巴实现圆寂了，但是在他的弟子面前呢他就修行六年以后呢他获得了成就。所以我们表面上看到这么一个小小的颂词，就短短的颂词，但实际上它带来的作用呢应该是无法想象的。
So actually, this verse is very famous. Maybe for some of you, you have studied the words of my perfect teacher. And in this book, there is a Geshe Chakwa, and he saw this verse in the book of Geshe Sharwa. And in order to find the lineage or the transmission of this text, he went from. 从哪儿到拉萨？
康区是吧？是康区吧？前期你们讲的是吧？没错吧？他们说没错。我记得是这样的，我当时讲的时候说是，我们从康区就是为了一个寄送要到拉萨的话，那个时候也没有车，也没有飞机，也没有货车。只有马车，只有拖拉机都没有。
So, in order to get this verse, he went from Kong district to Lhasa on foot. At that time, there was no other traffic, and then by the time he went, he got Lhasa the Lhasa was already Geshe Lhasa was already passed away, and then he got the lineage from one of his disciples, and then he meditated upon this verse for 6 years, and in the end he completely cut the self-grasping mind and realize the true nature of his mind. So if we see this verse, it's actually very short, but but it can have a great function.
可能我们在生活当中啊，很多的这种失败，自己成熟的话呢，也是对现在人的一些历练，就是也许可能有相味的。但是呢，真正让奉献自己的人来讲呢，这也是非常有意义的。所以我们实践当中的很多的优秀的人呢，他愿意就是做我的这种奉献，也愿意呢自己承受一些失败。有时候我们对大乘佛教的个别的理念，你不能马上轻易的认可或者是接受的话呢，我认为这是情有可原的。你逐渐思维它的意义， 同时呢也像了解我们世界当中所发生的许许多多的事情的时候呢，你也可能会有一个预定，哦，原来大乘佛教所讲的确实很伟大。
And so here it said that if we follow these verses, then there will be a lot of failures in our life, and it may be still a bit contradict to our current way of thinking. And but actually, for some good people now, it is very meaningful to really sacrifice ourselves, to really can take defeat upon ourselves and give victory to others. And for some ideas of, for some features of the Mahayana Dharma, it is okay that you cannot accept it, you know, right now, but you should think about it, you should reflect upon it, think of the meaning of it, and after you know, and also know a lot of things happening now, and in the end, you will have a different opinion or a different feeling.
下面第七个种子第六个是吧刚拉的个盘的把瑞瓦奇瓦刚一个新的某个诺那样新年蛋白到了胸那么这个种子的意思呢就是说我在生活当中呢非常尽心尽力的帮助别人但是呢这个人不但对我报恩反而呢就是对我危害相当大就是以各种方式来损害我那么这个时候呢我们不能就是不但不报处就是反而把它当作自己的善知识就是自己的根本上是那样来对待
So, the sixth verse reads, even when someone I have helped or in whom I have placed great hopes mistreats me very unjustly, I will view that person as a true spiritual teacher. So here is a talk about the situation that in our life, you know, we help someone really hard, but then the person, really mistreats us unjustly and he even do harm to us and but here it says that we should view that person we shouldn't get revenge and we should view that person as a true spiritual teacher or as our root lama
这也是我们在生活当中经常发生的我们身边有很多人不报恩德的人恩将出报的人或者说忘恩负义的人那么这个时候呢我们如果把它当作一个真正的善知识那样的话呢实际上这是一个最好的一个修行的机会其实修行的机会呢我们不一定到一个善里面去闭关啊禅修啊跟任何人借助不了不借助的地方去禅修其实这个一个人在一个屋子里面就禅修就比较容易但是在我们社会上面对就各种各样的复杂的这种事情各种各样的人群的时候才发现就是自己的修行的境界甚至呢也会发现就是自己真正修行的机会就是以此而这个现前
So this kind of situation also happens a lot in our daily life because we will meet a lot of people you know when we do something good to them and you know they will not pay anything back but we should treat them as a true spiritual teacher because actually this person gives us or provides us with a great opportunity to practice the Dharma And you know, sometimes you don't need to go to a mountain, go to a solitude, you know, to do meditation. You will not communicate with other people. You will not get in touch with other people, because it is sometimes easier to do meditation in a single room. But when you really go to the society, you will face lots of different kinds of things, and you will meet different kinds of people. So by that time, you will see your actual state of practice, and then maybe the chance or the opportunity for you to practice it will come.
好，第七个颂词，多纳我当月巴依潘德马南格兰巴马尤诺当登格尔格桑尤达拉林巴尔修。嗯，总而言之，我们直接或者说是间接的让所有的快乐奉献给老母有情。所有天下的这些众生，而天下这些众生的痛苦、困难、障碍，包括一些他们的这个罪恶的话呢，默默的我自己代受，就是这是一种自他交换，或者说是换位思考的一种修行方法。
So, the seventh verse reads, in brief, directly or indirectly, I will offer help and happiness to all my mothers and secretly take upon myself all their hurt and suffering. In this verse, it talks about, you know, we should benefit all the sentient beings or all the living beings, and we should secretly take upon all their hurt and all their suffering and all their negative karma. So actually this verse talk about that we should, sometimes we should think in others' position or the practice of exchanging self and others.
那么这里就讲到了，我们只要有办法，有时候是可能自己包括领导啊、官员啊，或者说上人啊等等，来就是直接帮助众生。有时候可能我们自己帮助众生的这种机会没有，但通过另一种方式来间接的去帮助别人，那么这就是全部都是无有条件的，就无有条件的自愿的一种帮助众生的心态和行为。这就是大乘佛教就非常重视的最重要的一个这个菩萨心。
And for some people, you can benefit others directly. Maybe you are a leader and you are official and you are merchant, so you can benefit others directly.But for some other people, you can also benefit others indirectly, but all of them should be unconditional and you should do it voluntarily. So this is a particular bodhisattva practice in the Mahayana Dharma.
大乘佛教就利益众生的这种精神呢，就相当于是母亲对孩子的这种母爱，甚至有些时候远远超过他。我们在座的人可能知道，母亲对孩子的爱跟这个其他的，包括男女之间的感情啊，或者说是我们与朋友之间的这种感情啊，我认为是完全不相同的。
So it is like the maternal love, the love that the mother towards the child. Sometimes the bodhisattva practice of Mahayana Dharma is even greater than the maternal love. And I think that there is big difference between the maternal love and other relationship, like the relationship between man and woman and the relationship between some friends.
母亲对孩子的爱呢？当然母亲当中可能极少数的对不爱孩子，但这是1%左右，而99%的母亲呢，对孩子的这种爱是无条件的，也就是说 在某种情况下孩子非常的不听话，甚至他做的特别过分，但是作为母亲呢，一直长期的就只要是让他好的话，无论是他怎么样，我还是可以忍耐，我可以原谅他。
我可以什么？
原谅他。
啊，原谅。And so, the maternal love or the love that mother toward the child, maybe there's only 1% of the mothers who don't love their child or children, but I think 99% of the mothers, they will love their child or children unconditionally or voluntarily. You know, in some certain cases, the children may, you know, they've been very naughty, they do some extremely things, but in a long time, you know, always the mother can endure and forgive, can endure all of this and can forgive the children.
世间的很多的爱呢，不是这样的，就很多人说，我可以，如果你对我好的话呢，我可以付出一切。但一旦你对我不好的时候，或者是你对我没有这种欢喜心和爱的时候呢，我也是对你不客气。所以，这样的这种心态跟母爱呢，有非常大的差别。
So there is clear a difference between the maternal love and other relationships in the world, because for some other relationships, it's not like that. It's that if I do something good to you, if you do something good to me, and then I will do something good to you, and I'm willing to sacrifice everything. But if you don't, but if you treat me bad, and I will also get revenge and treat you badly.
因此，大乘佛教对众生，自己或者是间接的这种利他方式呢，我们在座的各位呢，都应该深深的思维。
So the Mahayana Dharma that you know. We should benefit all living beings, all living creatures, and directly or indirectly. So this kind of idea or this kind of spirit, I think all of us should think about it and reflect upon it.
最后一个颂词，得到根将求积极，多不知没马不着将，求根一门西比路，人品强哇。
那么最后一个颂词的意思呢，就是说我们上面所讲到的这些呢，都最好不要被世间八法这个所染污。也就是说，世间八法呢，我们在座的应该大家都知道，人们都喜欢喜酒、快乐、礼养、供养啊、什么这个赞叹和名声等，不喜欢他的反面的四个，这样的一种世间八法没有染污的，在身影当中一切万法是空性的，在世俗当中如梦如幻如洋洋淡、如洋洋淡，就是以这个幻化八语来这个色测，就是说降到一个大乘这个中观空性方面的一个最高的见解。
So the last verse reads, I will learn to keep all these practices untainted by thoughts of the eight worldly concerns. May I recognize all things are like illusions and without attachment gain freedom from bondage. So actually this tells us that all these practices should be untainted by the eight worldly concerns or the eight worldly dharma. So the eight worldly dharmas, you know, a lot of people we want to be praised and we want to be happy and we want to be gain and we want to be famous and we don't like the opposite of that. And in this verse it tells us actually in the absolute truth, it is emptiness and it's non-conceptual and beyond all extremes. But in the relative truth, you know, in the world that we are living, it is like dreams or like illusions, and we use eight metaphors of we sometimes use eight metaphors. So this is metonymical or the middle way. It talks about emptiness. This is the highest understanding in the Mahayana Dharma.
这个最后的一个颂词呢，关于中观方面的道理，我今天因为时间关系不多讲。你们最好呢，看看这个全真门分仁波切的中观专业论释，还有呢，这个还有关于幻化方面的一些道理的话呢，你们多看一下全职龙清然见的这个虚幻休息，这些等种呢就是讲得非常清楚。他这个颂词里面最后讲，就是这个修行八颂是这个无量光化身，阿弥陀佛的化身，就是是朗日唐巴格西所造啊。就我们这个修行八颂呢，就以此而讲解圆满。最后还有一件事情，
So this verse talk about the middle way or metonymica. Because of the time limitation, I will not say a lot about it. But I suggest that of the middle way, you can refer to the ornament of the middle way, which is composed by the great Khenpo Rinpoche, and about all things are like illusion. But illusion, you can also look at the finding comfort and ease in illusion, which is composed by the great Longchenpa. So it is clearly identified there. So in the end, it is said that the verse is composed by the Geshe Langri Tangpa, which is the Zugu of the Amitabha.
时间到了是吧？刚好。就有两件事情。第一个事情是，当会儿我可能念，一个讲，也将用藏语来讲一个宗喀巴大师的三柱要道论，但是呢，很多人可能不懂藏语的人就不一定听得懂，但不过就是在里面就念一个传承而已。还有一个呢，昨天下午的时候，这个尼泊尔发生了8.1级的地震，然后这个死亡的人数呢，就是现在也不断都是在增长。所以我们对遇难者也好，就是对这个伤亡的人也好，对生存的人呢，都要一方面抱有他们，一方面就是超度他们，希望大家一起念这个108遍观音菩萨的心咒，求观音菩萨加持，救苦救难，就是解脱，就解脱彼岸。
And so there are two things, and later I will teach the three principles of the path created by the Tsongkhapa, but for some of you, you may not understand Tibetan, so you will just get a lineage of it. And there is another thing that yesterday afternoon, there is a massive 8.1 magnitude earthquake happened in Nepal, and lots of people and the number of the people died in this catastrophe or accident still increase. And so we should do and then for the dead people, also for the injured people, for the suffered people, we should pray to them. So let's recite the mantra of the Avalokiteshvara, so in order to get the benefit, get the blessings of the Avalokiteshvara, and send them to the liberation.
Junji Maku, Kumdo Kazosan, Yiji, Walajan, Tuji, Changin Rola, Shunazula, Soran, the Oman Bama, 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 Umarna ba meori 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 Uman ba me ore man 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 Umarna ba me ore man 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 ba me Umarna ba me ore man 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 ba me Umarna ba me ore man 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 Umarna ba me ore Givan de yim yerde dal chare zon jirne roa chigyan mali
So I'm really grateful that for all the people that we studied together tonight. And we really appreciate your time with us. I remember one Catholic practitioner said, once said that the whole idea of compassion is based on a keen awareness of the interdependence of all living beings, which are all part of one another and all involved in one another.
非常感谢您的聆听。我记得一位天主教道修道士也曾说过，整个慈悲的内涵是基于一种敏锐的觉知，也就是觉知到所有生命的相互依赖性，我们是不可分割的一个整体，我们彼此相互依赖。
The world today, we have sufficient material resources, a massive knowledge, advanced technology, convenient transportation, and so on. However, we still cannot achieve happiness and peace in the world, so we must lack something of great importance. We cannot gain happiness and peace only through material means. We must rely upon the compassion and wisdom in Mahayana Dharma. Wish Rinpoche's teaching will light up your life with compassion and wisdom, which you can implement the teaching within your daily life and eventually realize the true meaning of life. See you next time.
21世纪的今天，整个世界已经拥有充足的物质资源、海量的知识信息、先进的科技、便捷的交通等等。然而大多数人并没有因此而获得属于自己的宁静与幸福，那么应该是我们忽略了某些重要的东西。那么是的，依靠大乘佛法的智慧与慈悲，才能给我们带来单靠外在物质难以触及到的幸福与平和，因为这种幸福与平和实际上源自于我们的内心。希望仁波切今晚的开示能够令慈悲与智慧点亮您的人生，愿您在生活中运用与实践这些教法，并最终了悟生命的真谛。我们下次再见。
Let's dedicate the merit to all living beings by chanting the essence of the ocean of aspiration.
下面，请大家把今晚的所有功德回向给一切有情众生，让我们一起念诵《愿海精髓》。
Sodargye Rinpoche, Khenpo Sodargye, Dharma, Sodargye, 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 S
Jiu